Hello, everybody. Hi, I
We
can
are
hear everyone.
live.
Live. It's Andrea Ball and Phyllis Kerr. So we got to make sure we've got our feedback not broadcasting there. So good. Okay, great. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. We are talking about social media strategy today, and we're really going to dive into what's working. How do you set up a social media strategy? I just want to make sure, can people hear us? People are saying you can't hear. If you need to turn on the little volume button in the lower right corner if you can't hear us. Sometimes it defaults to off, so hopefully you can hear.
Thank goodness.
Yes.
But in this case, turn it on.
That's right.
And you might have to refresh if you're watching on a desktop.
Yeah. So welcome, everyone. We're just going to do a little introduction in case people don't know us. I'm Andrea Ball, and I worked extensively with Phyllis on the Facebook Marketing All-in-One for Dummies book. Usually I have one handy that I can pull over, but I don't. We worked, there you go. There's all the books behind Phyllis. And we also are the co-founders of Social Media Manager School and Social Media Strategy School. And I guess
yes,
I did your introduction, basically.
I know. That's all right. We've been doing this for so long, and we just assume people know who we are. But we could just be two weird people, you know, showing up in their feed today. So it's really fun to be here. I love Facebook Live, and we have a lot of things that we can share with you today, especially about social media marketing. And this idea of a social media strategy is very interesting because Andrea and I have been noticing that a lot of businesses are just posting. You know, they just have this sort of very thin sort of idea of, oh, we should post about this, or we should post about that. But they really don't have a strategy in place yet. And so we're very excited to talk about this today.
Right. Because I think, you know, what happens if you're just, you hear these things like you need to post X number of times at 2 o'clock, or this needs to happen. And those are guidelines that people put out there for the different social sites. But what is missing with that is the real strategy behind what you're doing and really focusing in on, is this really furthering my business? People just post and hope. That's what I call it, is just you post and hope that it works. And you really don't have, first of all, you don't have the measurement strategies in place that you need to have to be able to tell if it's working. You don't have a real focused goal on what you're even trying to measure. What are you trying to accomplish there? And you need to know how to measure that. And then you need to assess and determine if that's working for you. So let's,
you know, and it's really interesting. I'm glad you brought this up about the tracking bit, because to me now, a strategy is completely tied to the tracking. So you don't have a strategy unless you also have the mechanisms in place to track what's working or what isn't working. It's totally, they're vital to each other.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so definitely. It's a challenge because, you know, you need to understand what's the right measurements for your business, because, you know, there's all kinds of guidelines out there about, like, oh, you should, you know, be tracking conversions, you'd be tracking engagement, tracking reach. People like to look at how many likes they have on Facebook. But is that really what is going to move the needle for your business? So let's talk about a little bit about, hopefully people can hear. If you are listening on your phone, try turning up the media volume if you're not able to hear. And Michelle's saying hit it up on the top if you're not able to hear that. So awesome. So let's talk first about setting different goals for your business. Like, what can social media do for you? And there's lots of possibilities. It can be great for awareness. You can, you know, think about how you first interact with a brand. How did you become aware of that? Think about your customer journey and kind of realize how it might happen for your customers. Sometimes it's about a shared post on Facebook and it looks really good. And so you go over to their website and start reading some of their blog posts and you become aware of that business or product or service that's available. So in those cases, maybe your initial goal is I want brand awareness, and my key performance indicators, my success metrics there are going to be things like reach. Am I getting reach? Am I getting engagement? You know, am I getting shares? Maybe you're going to be watching that. And then what you need to do is determine what types of content is furthering that for you. What's really like, you know, moving the needle for you and really diving into those back-end insights and the metrics to see does this post get more reach or is it the post about kittens? You know,
it's always the post about kittens. It's always, you know, it's interesting. You bring up one of my favorite topics, and that is what is attractive to your audience. And mm-hmm. a lot of people will post content, but they're not doing it in a way that's attractive to their audience. And one of the things that I really like to say is when you're on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram or whatever, notice why you stop scrolling. Mm-hmm. What is it that makes you stop? Right? Because whatever that is, there's something about it that's attractive specifically to you as an audience. So you have to find those things that your audience loves to see, loves the visual of, loves the vocabulary, loves the tone of the voicing. You know, all of those things are really important when designing content. Mm-hmm. So it's, you have to think about it a little bit and you have to test it. We're real big into testing, right?
For sure. For sure. That's one thing that a lot of people don't do. It's the post and hope, you know.
That's putting on a t-shirt, baby. That's going to do it. That's a new one.
Do not post and hope.
Well, you know, it's very interesting because you mentioned awareness as being one of the goals. And so if your strategy is to build a bigger community and your goal is to increase it by 200 a month, okay, then you have to build those posts that are attractive to the audience that will make that, you know, goal happen, that will support the goal. So you can see that there's specific steps you need to go through. And that's what's really cool about our school is we're very clear about first you do this, then you do this, then you do this, then you do that. Right. And instead of the post and hope bit.
Yeah. Yeah. So let's talk about, so we're kind of talking about brand awareness as a goal. Let's talk about maybe a different type of goal. Let's talk about traffic to your website. Let's say you know your website is where all the magic happens. You know, people get over there, they see your product, there's lots you can do when people get to your website. You know, that maybe you've got an opt-in or maybe you've got some pop-up that helps grow your email list in that way. So another strategy would be to let's try and increase our website traffic from social media. So what you need to do in that case is have the measurement systems in place, which would be Google Analytics. You really need Google Analytics. It's free. Just go to google.com/analytics if you haven't gotten that on your site already. But you really can learn so much about your website visitors when you install that. And what you can see there is how much traffic are you getting from social? Which social sites are driving the most traffic for you? And when you try new tactics, are you increasing the amount of traffic? Are you getting, you know, seeing that bump that you want to see, that increment that is getting you closer to that goal? So some of the tactics that we're talking about, goals, and we didn't even kind of touch on yet, the difference between the strategies and the tactics. But some of the tactics you might have is let's just post more often, or let's create some content that is really going to be interesting on that we can drive traffic to. You know, maybe it's about analyzing what blog posts have done well in the past for you, posting those more often, bringing up those evergreen posts and reposting them to say, let's just boost our traffic with social and let's, see if we post more often or if we post at different times, if that really helps us, or which blog posts are always a winner. Whenever we post them, they get lots of traffic. So it's about kind of the setting up the goal, setting up that success metric, that key performance indicator, trying some tactics, and then analyzing the result to see, did that help?
Right. And as far as a tactic goes, an example of a good tactic would be, especially if you have a product or a service that's quite visual or is instructional, you can create blog posts that have extremely beautiful images that are set up for Pinterest. And then you drive traffic from Twitter and Facebook to your blog post and have it so easy to pin that things are pinning. Now, when you start tracking your traffic from Pinterest inside of Google Analytics, you'll see if this strategy is working for you. And I can tell you, it works. It's a very powerful strategy, but you have to have all those other pieces in play. You have to know what you're tracking. Like Andrew was talking about, you have to know what your strategy is. You have to understand your audience and what you're posting. And you have to have systems in place to make that fluid. But doing that inside of a blog post with beautiful images to Pinterest is one of those tactics that will support your goal of your strategy.
So let's step back a second and talk a little bit about tactics versus strategy, because we talked about kind of the first thing you need to have in place is that those goals and the measurement systems that you're going to be watching. So what are your key performance indicators? What's going to, because that's the thing about all the metrics that you can track. It's overwhelming, right? It's like, you get into Google Analytics, it's like, oh my gosh, where do I go? I don't know.
And Google Analytics is very addictive once you get inside there too, so be forewarned.
Yeah, and so if you can go into Google Analytics and you can actually create these awesome dashboards that even just pull out the only metrics you care about, and you can go in there, take a minute and say, yep, we've increased over last week. We tried that new tactic. So we talked about kind of the goals and the metrics that you put in place. But now let's talk a little bit about strategies versus tactics and what that difference is. So really, the strategy is kind of the big picture. It's really about, let's write down, what is our goal? How are we measuring it? What's our voice? What's our kind of overarching things are we going to do to get closer to our goal? What, are we going to use content? Are we going to use ads? Are we going to, what kinds of big picture tactics are going to really be part of our strategy to launch this product or to get more people into our, into our workshop or whatever that might be.
Right. So now in terms of strategies, there are really several big buckets that all strategies fall into. And we've talked a little bit about the content strategy. And a lot of people default to this. Businesses will default to a content strategy. But there's also this sort of like geeky keyword SEO hashtag strategy that some very savvy people are using with great success. And that's another kind of category of strategy. And then community, you have partners and affiliates and super fans and really working
brand ambassadors.
All of that is a whole nother. And then the last one is Andrea's favorite, which is social advertising, which works beautifully if you know how to do it. So you have to decide which one is best for your business, and or maybe there's a couple, or maybe there's a little bit of each, but you have to be really clear what you're doing inside of each of those strategies before you go posting or before you go doing anything.
Right. Yeah, because, any type of, especially if we're talking about a launch or something where you've got a really big push around some campaign, you only have one shot at it, and you have to lay your strategy out ahead of time so you're not frantically, you know, the night before something is supposed to happen, you realize you didn't contact the brand ambassadors to let them know, you know, or whatever that might be, or you haven't done any ad testing to find out what your best audiences are, and now you've got a week before the launch and you don't know which audiences work. So there's, you want to have a longer range plan to launch something, especially. And the great thing, if you are launching the same thing multiple times, like we've done with some of our products, is that you really get to test different strategies. We've done things like affiliate marketing. We've tested different lead generators. We've tested different titles. We've tested different types of ads for each of our launches that we've done for our products. And it's what ends up happening is you just distill it down to the perfect strategies for the next launch, and you get better and better. So that's a cool thing if you can have multiple launches, but sometimes you've only got one shot at it. So you've got to plan way ahead to put all the pieces in place, like the measurement systems, like what content and strategy you are going to have. So for example, when we had a really big push around Social Media Manager School a few years ago, we were planning months in advance with, let's get all the content ready to go. So we were 3 months ahead of time, we were writing all this content and all these guest posts and getting all the content for the affiliate marketers, because that was one of our pieces as well. And then when, you know, a month out, we had the dates lined up so we could say, okay, this is when this has to happen, and we're going to drop this content in, we're going to release all the guest posts. So it looked like we were, you know, looked like we were everywhere. So that's kind of a cool thing.
And especially if you're using video to market, of course you can do live video, but having video that's already been created that you can upload and use, or shooting interviews with people and then having the time to edit those and make them look really nice, or creating bits and pieces that are evergreen that you can use over and over and over again, that takes planning. And so, you know, it used to be back in the day when we did social media marketing, it was a very quick, oh, let's do this thing very quickly. But now, to really be successful, I really do think you have to take a step back, just like we do, and really plan and figure out what works and what doesn't work.
For sure. For sure.
Yep.
So let's talk a little bit really quickly about our webinar that we have, because we can't cover everything in this short thing, but we have this awesome webinar on 4 strategies and 3 tactics to grow your business on every social site. So let me post that in the links.
We really pack that webinar with a lot of good stuff in that one. So if you go by and take a look at that, it'll tell you all that this whole structure that we've developed for Social Media Strategy School. And I think it's really fabulous. I'm very excited about it.
Yeah. So I tried putting it in the little show button, but I think it cuts off. I'm going to stop that. I was just testing that out.
Do you see it?
Okay, good. Yeah. Okay, good. Did it get cut off? It didn't get cut off. All right. Awesome.
Oh, it does get cut off on one part, but my view, it's beautiful.
Okay. Awesome. All right. Well, I put it in the comments. So that's a resource for you. Go and listen to that webinar. We really dive into the strategies and tactics, and we give you specific examples on every social site about how to grow your business with these tactics, as well as really planning out your strategy a little bit. So, and then I also want to give a shout out, and then we'll open it up for questions here. I also want to give a shout out to our awesome, awesome new training that I'm so excited about. And this will show up for sure. It's Social Media Strategy School. And we have been working on this and developing this for years, really. But it's all updated with tons of great it's a great combination of strategy and really planning your strategy. You've got worksheets in there. You really kind of map that out. And then we go through all the social sites and all the, and also go through the ROI of how you set up your tracking. How do you get into Google Analytics? What do you pay attention to? And really talk about that piece of it, because that is a big missing piece a lot of times is with these trainings, is really setting up that tracking so that you know when social media is really working for you. Because a lot of people say, oh, I don't know when social media is working for me. But the truth is, social media is one of the most trackable ways of marketing that we have. You know, it really, you really can see when you have the right tracking in place, when someone comes from Facebook, and if they were to purchase on your site, you can track all the way through that funnel. And, you know, there's really cool things that are available to you. That
and Twitter.
And Twitter. I talk about Facebook all the time. I know.
Every social site has its own analytics, but to be able to track through from something like an ad or a post, then you really need to have that understanding of how to use tracking links and how to see them in Google Analytics and all of that. So it's really important. So that is a major part of Social Media Strategy School. We have a huge lesson on it. And there's also lessons in there about Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and Pinterest and YouTube and Google and and LinkedIn. I always forget LinkedIn for some weird reason.
LinkedIn block.
Yeah, so awesome. We have a few questions.
Yeah, let's answer some questions here. So we have a question from Mohammed that says, what is the best social media analytics tool? And that's a really challenging question to answer because there are so many tools. It really can depend on what you are interested in tracking. But I really do believe that Google Analytics, which is free, is one of the best ways that you can track out there. There are lots of other great tools that give you reports around how things are growing, what kind of engagement you're getting. There's things like Agora Pulse, Sprout Social.
Social Media Report.
Yes, Social Media Report is great. eClincher gives you some reports, right? It gives you, and then Syfe. Yes. Syfe is another wonderful dashboard tool that you can pull in all the analytics. So some of
And every social site has its own analytics too.
Exactly.
So use those first.
Yeah. So I think that's a big thing is, and the hard thing is that a lot of these tools are paid, most of them. I don't think some of them have like a little bit of a free trial. But the only free one is Google Analytics. And that, I would start there. It is a little daunting when you get started because there are so many things available to track. But if you can go through and kind of pull out those great dashboards or, you know, pick out just the exact things you want to see, then that can really help you. So awesome. So great. We'll post the tool names here in the comments. I can't do it quite all at the same time, but I will post the tool names in the comments so you can see those. So awesome. Let's see. So Jennifer's asking, how do you easily use Google Analytics to attach all of your sources? The tracking codes aren't very straightforward on how and where to put them. So the thing that happens with Google Analytics that you have to kind of understand, if I'm understanding this question right, is that Google Analytics will pull in where your traffic is coming from, like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, things like that. What they have available is something called UTM codes, which are ways that you can attach information to a link so that you can specifically track that link. And in our Social Media Strategy School, we go through this in detail. We have a piece on how to do this and how to set this up. And but it really can help you, because then you know that link that came into your site came from your post, not from some other random post that's out there that someone is sharing. But you know that is from your efforts. And you can put that tracking code on there. It's just a little bit of additional code, and you set up kind of the the system for how you want, what you want the campaign name to be, the source and the medium. And then, you know, you just kind of have a running set of codes that you keep so that you know which ones are yours. And then you can look at that information in the campaign data in Google Analytics. So it's all very trackable, and it's all, it's a great way to kind of split out the traffic that you are posting about, and that makes sure that it ties that to your own efforts. So I hope that helps.
And you'll see this. I know everybody will recognize this. If you get something in an email or something and you click the link, if you check real quick up in the URL, if you see a really long URL that has campaign, medium, source, things like that, then they're using trackable links, and you can do that too. And when you click that, when it had a trackable link, they get that in their analytics that it was clicked from email, for example. Right. So it's really a great thing to do. So this is a great question. When you said to track your site, do you mean the squeeze page or the WordPress site?
Generally
we mean your WordPress site, except that a lot of landing pages do have the ability to put code on them so that you can track. So Facebook code and Twitter website tag code and all sorts of things. So it really depends. Now, some landing page systems are a little trickier to do that, and some are easier. Right. So it really just depends on what you're using.
So some, you know, if you do have a tool such as, say, for example, leadpages.net, they have a place where you can add in code, and you need to add in your Google Analytics code. You also will add in your Facebook Pixel code in there. And again, we talk about this all in the training on how to find those codes, put those into the places and all that stuff. So, yeah, awesome. Let's see, what other questions do we have? So great. Oh, Keith is looking at live presentation. This is actually BeLive.tv. It's a great free tool that you can use to make this dual screen Facebook Live. So it's super awesome. You can like put little comments up. You can broadcast
schedule, which is really nice.
Schedule.
Because you can schedule it, you can share it around, and wherever that is posted, when we go live, the video is there. So it's a very, very cool tool.
Yeah. So any other questions here that we have? Let's see. So great.
I think we got them all. Okay, hey, we're doing pretty good here.
We are doing good. Any other questions that we missed or whatever, feel free to answer any questions. But I would encourage you, if you need to know about how to put together your social media strategy, I would definitely encourage you to come check out socialmediastrategyschool.com. If you want to get a free class and see a little bit more about that, you can go to that socialmediastrategyschool.com/grow-your-business. So that will give you that free class there. Any other final things we
have? Just a quick question about supporting us. We happily take on affiliates. You're very welcome to go, and you can talk to us, or we can put some information in the comments a little bit later to answer your question. But yes, we love working with people.
Yep,
absolutely.
We do have affiliate opportunities with this, so it's great if you have people. You have people who need that type of training. So we'll just answer. I know we're kind of coming down to winding down, but Laura just joined us. I'm going to put your question up there. Email, any thoughts as part of a strategy? And actually, this is a great question because we didn't kind of get into this about how your strategy fits with your larger business strategy because email fits in, your website fits in, SEO on your website fits into that, all kinds of other, like, you know, copywriting, it all fits together. And email is a huge part of what I think a good social media strategy has. And it's really about using social media to grow your email list and then having the email sequence do the selling for you. So that is a fabulous strategy. And you can measure how many people are opting in from each social site when you have some sort of email offer. I don't necessarily recommend having just a general newsletter. Sign up for our newsletter unless you have some real key points about what your newsletter talks about and how awesome it is. But I do think that you know, it can't happen, but having something valuable that you give away is a good strategy for that.
And remember when we talked about content and the SEO and the partners and the social advertising, email is about having that content area and knowing what's attractive and knowing the words that's going to make somebody click to open and having that all organized is that type of strategy. That's where it falls, is inside that content strategy and also the keywords, because there are some words that some audiences will always click to open and some they will just delete. So you have to know that. Yes, absolutely. Email is very important for a strategy.
Yeah. So awesome. I think that's all we have time for right now. Thank you guys for joining us. This will be available on a replay since it's Facebook Live, same link. So if you just joined us late, feel free to watch the beginning of this. And oh, let me just quickly put in one more resource for you. I wrote a blog post that actually also has a link to the free training in there. I wrote a blog post about what's working now. We give some examples in there and kind of talk about the different types of strategies. But then definitely I would highly recommend you grab that free webinar that we've got at the end. It's really awesome. So cool.
All right.
Thanks, everybody.
Bye-bye, everybody.
See ya.
Bye-bye.